And he gets better and better. Just, it's not like one day he suddenly, you know, becomes a champion. He just works at it. That's what you have to do. So start with meditation and focus on what it is you want to do after you achieve that still state. If you still have all this jabbering going on and thoughts, you're not going to be very effective. You can still have intent. You know, the difference, there's a difference there. You read a book about the power of positive thinking, right? Well, positive thinking is the same sort of thing. It's an intent. You intend for positive things to happen, and that works. There's nothing, you know, that works the same way. But it's the difference between sun coming through a window and it feels nice and warm. That's what you get with positive thinking. Or a big magnifying glass that brings that same amount of sun in that window and can burn, you know, through a piece of steel. It's all the same sun, you know, the same amount. One of it is a unfocused, positive thinking kind of thing, and it works. It warms, but you can do so much more if you can focus that, you know, real well. So that's kind of the difference. But positive thinking is, it's all part of the same thing, and it does work.
The hemisync tapes, is that optional, essential?
No, it's not essential. All of that's optional. That's another tool. What the hemisync tapes will do, well, it will put you into a altered state, like a meditation state. It'll put you there and then kind of fasten you there, kind of locks you into that state so that you can experience that state. Now, that's good news and bad news. The good news is that if you can't achieve that state on your own, it'll help you experience it. The bad news is that after you've learned to achieve that state on your own, it'll lock you in and you can't get out of it because it's playing these tones. The way it works is with a binaural beat. It'll put one frequency in one ear and a frequency plus about 4 hertz in the other ear, and those two frequencies go into the opposite, you know, to the hemispheres of your brain, and they meet at the corpus callosum, which is the center part of your brain, and they actually get a beat frequency going, and you can hear the beat going. It's not, you know, pure tone in either ear, but you hear the beat because your brain now is oscillating with that beat. And what it does is entrains your brainwaves. Suddenly your brainwaves have a lot more energy in the lower alpha theta region. So this is what it kind of forces. But it's a trap as well as a boost. So you can do that, but if that's all you do, you won't get beyond that. There's a time when you need to stop saying the mantra and go on without it because you no longer need it. There's a time to take off the headphones and stop listening to the beats because you've outgrown them. They're like training wheels. So if you need training wheels, that's good. After a while, you need to let that go because it'll hold you back. If you're already at that point consciousness, to leave it and say, oh, I'm not saying the mantra. I'm just sitting here in the void. You know, that's the wrong thing to do. You, like, you've gotten there. That'll pull you back. You need to let the mantra go and just experience that state. Now you've progressed beyond the point of needing that mantra. It's, so the tapes can be useful. You have to know when to quit.
Sorry, just to pick up what somebody else was saying. So when you die, you lose the physical body, mm-hmm. but you're still a consciousness. So therefore, can you choose to have another physical experience? And it can obviously be in any one of the...
Yes, you can have another physical experience, and you can have it in a different physical reality than this one. You can take a longer or shorter time between times. Most people tend to return to the same physical reality, particularly beginners, because they already know the ropes. They know the culture. They kind of know how it works. So they tend to constantly come back to the same physical matter reality. It's kind of like their home base. But you can. There's nothing that keeps you from going to any of the others. They're available if they're inside of that green thing I said that was sort of N division. If you go outside of that, then it's a little different. Now it's not only the culture's different, but everything gets a little weirder. And that doesn't happen as often, but you can. It happens that you go through that. So yes, you can do that. Part of the things you do when you're in that process, after you've passed out of this reality, some of the things you do first is review what you had here. You go into those reality databases I was talking about, and you get to look, because there'll be somebody, you know, your whole life's there, everything you thought and did, and somebody will talk to you and you'll say, yeah, but look, I did this really well. And you shouldn't say that unless you really can mean it, because the facts are on the board and they'll roll the movie. and show what you really were thinking at that time and what you were intending, and you go, oh, well, yeah, I guess I didn't do that too well. So that's part of your training then for and growing up as you get feedback from this system. That's part of what they use those databases for. So you can then decide, all right, I'm ready, I understand it now. I think what I'd like to do is work on this, and you'll get help and you'll decide. And basically, if you are far enough along, you will do a lot of the planning for your incarnation, including sometimes coming back so that you interact with special people or friends. You know, you can do all that. But if you're not, if you're just at a very lower level in the very beginning of this, there's not a whole lot of planning. It's like pop in, pop out. You know, you get out, you turn around, dive back in again, because you don't really know enough to learn a lot at that point. You just need to gain experience. You just have to have some experience. So it depends how much planning you do.
Is it just humans that experience consciousness?
No. Everything that is sentient experiences consciousness. But they all have different, what do you call them, decision space. I call it decision space. Okay, and remember that rock rolling downhill had a very small decision space. There's not much it could do. A dog, a cat, you know, a fox has a lot more decision space. It has choices to make, things that it can do or not do. It's conscious. If it's conscious, it's part of the whole, just like we are. Everything that's conscious is part of the overall consciousness system, and it's evolving. It's just doing it on a, in a different path, in a different way. And perhaps when that very clever monkey, your dog, develops enough, he may decide to come and try out a human. Consciousness evolves. It goes up the ladder, you see. So, they're all conscious. They're all aware. I mean, even anything that's sentient, which means it interacts, a clam, you know, just a little mushy-headed clam lying at the bottom of the sea, if it has its foot out and you poke that foot, it'll pull its foot in. It's sentient. It has consciousness, but just a teeny little decision space. There's not a whole lot of decisions it makes, but it makes a few. But within that decision space, that clam has free will. It's consciousness. It is conscious.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you experience what beyond the human level as a human? Is it possible, you know, to be able to get in touch with the next level? I don't know whether it's angels or how you'd like to, you know.
Oh, sure. Sure, you can. When you can leave this physical, you know, that's not a difficult thing to do. You know, it's just something you have to work at. But when you get out into that reality, most people who travel in the non-physical do it within that area I said was OS. It's just a little tiny part of the non-physical that interacts with the physical, and you can learn to do that probably in 6 months or a year if you work on it very methodically. But do it in ways that are evidential, so that you'll know that you're not imagining it. Do things that you can come back later and know that you're experiencing something outside of yourself. That's the key thing. You have to do experiments. You have to be a scientist when you go out there. Otherwise, you'll just never know what you've got or what you're doing. That's really key. Other questions? Have we just really gone past our time? Are we going to be thrown out soon? Okay, well, thank you all very much. I do appreciate the opportunity. Thank you.